Hello, Falcons and Golden Eagles. My name is Debbie Lou Angeles, and I am the West Hills College Lemoore Educational Technology Specialist. Today, I want to walk you through how to register for classes using our newly redesigned student portal. With the new student portal comes a new landing page, so let's take a look at that first. You will still access the landing page the same way, and that is by going to westhillscollege.com or any of the campus-specific websites and clicking on the My West Hills button towards the top right of the page. On the screen now is the original landing page that I'm sure everyone is used to. The new landing page looks like this. The first thing you might notice is that there are now separate login buttons for each campus. This means you can select whether you want to log into Lemoore, Kalinga, or the Firebaugh Center so that you can get the information that is most relevant to your location. You also have easy access to some helpful links such as the reset password button and the list of numbers to call if you need help logging in. For this demonstration, I will be logging into the Lemoore student portal. Before that, take note that when I click the button, I will not be asked to log in because I'm already logged into a district computer. When you click the button, you will most likely be sent to the login portal to enter your username, password, and two-factor authentication code before getting into the student portal. Without further ado, let's go ahead and log in. Here in the new student portal, you have access to all of the same tools that you did in the old student portal. You still have the My Courses link to Canvas and the link to your student email right at the top, as well as the same self-service links, such as the ones to view your transcript and to petition to graduate. At the bottom of the portal page, you still have resources such as the academic calendar and your free Microsoft Office 365 download, as well as access to all student forms, such as financial aid forms and the basic needs request form. I won't go too deep into all of the things you have access to in the new portal, so I encourage you to click around and explore. What I do want to focus on in this video is registration. So let's scroll back to the top where you can find the steps to register to the right of the self-service area. If you are a current student, you'll notice that the process to register is still exactly the same, even with the new student portal. The first step, as always, is to make sure that all your agreements are completed. Clicking on the icon in the Complete Required Agreements section will take you straight to the Agreements page. In the Agreements page, click View and then click Accept for every agreement listed. You will not be able to register if even one agreement is not completed. To search for and plan classes, you can either go back to the student portal and click the icon in the Plan Your Courses section, or you can click on the graduation cap icon in the left-hand navigation menu, then click on Course Catalog. In the Course Catalog page, you can search for classes using a variety of different filters. You can use the term drop-down box to select a specific semester. You can enter specific start and end dates. You can select a specific subject in the subject drop-down box. And if you know the three-digit course number, you can enter that as well. You can even get a specific as a section number if you already know what section you want to register for. You can click the Add More button if you want to search for more than three classes at the same time. You can also specify what days of the week you want the classes to be on. This is especially useful if there are days that you know you can't attend class. There are also options to select a specific location. Lemoore off campus is for classes held at other locations, such as our dual enrollment classes at the high schools. Lemoore campus is for all classes that have any sort of synchronous requirements. This includes in-person classes, hybrid classes where at least one class meeting per week is done online, and online synchronous, which is an online class with specific mandatory meeting times, usually through Zoom. Lemoore Online is for fully online asynchronous classes, which means they do not have a specific mandatory meeting time. Kalinga and Firebaugh have similar location options with their online options, off-campus options, out-of-district options, and on-campus options. You can also select a time of day or enter specific start and end times. Finally, you can select specific course types. This filter is helpful for those who know they need a general education class, but they don't know what classes fall into the different areas. This is also where you can select only low textbook cost or even zero textbook cost courses. For this example, let's say that I am registering for the fall 2023 semester. I know I need a Math 41 College Algebra for STEM class, and an Art 42 art appreciation class. And I think I need a Psych 1 class. I want to search for 4 classes, so let's add one more row by clicking the Add More button and include all student development classes, because I know I need to take College Success, but I forgot the 3-digit course number. I also know that I don't want to take an online class, so I'm going to stick to Lamar campus, and I only want to see 0 textbook cost sections. Now let's click the Search button and see our options. The sections are divided up by course. To view the available sections for a course, just click anywhere in the View Available Sections box to expand the list of sections. Looking at the list for Math 41, you may notice that these first two and the second two have the same days, times, and room numbers. Let's learn more about the sections by either clicking the section name or the Add Section to Plan button to show the section details. The details show that Section L20 has a co-requisite course, or a course that you have to take at the same time. In this case, it is the support course Math 141, which is for students who need a little bit of extra class time to make sure they are successful in the class. I don't necessarily need that support course, so let's close this one and peek into the L21 section. This one does not have the co-requisite requirement, and I like the Monday-Wednesday meeting days, so I'm going to close the section details again and click the Add Section to Plan button. Again, this is another way to view the section details, but now I have another Add Section to Plan button on the bottom. I will click that to confirm that I want to add this section. And an alert will show at the top right-hand corner letting me know that the section was successfully planned. Take note that planning a class does not register you for the class, so you are not officially enrolled just yet. All it does is add the section to your student planning schedule. We will cover officially registering for planned classes in the next step. Let's go ahead and do the same process for Art 42. Moving on to Psych 1, I have an alert here in this section reminding me that I already took this course, so let's just skip it. Finally, here's that College Success class I was looking for. I like the schedule for the L1, L3, and L4 sections, but I'm not sure if I want the full 18-week option, the first 9-week option, or the second 9-week option. So let's just add all three and figure it out later. You can plan as many sections of the same class as you want. Doing this is helpful if you are not sure which section fits best with your schedule. Now that all of our classes are planned, we can move on to the third step, which is to register for our planned classes. Remember, all we did so far was search and plan the classes. To officially enroll, you can either go back to the student portal and click on the icon in the Register for Your Planned Classes section, or you can click on the graduation cap icon in the left-hand navigation menu. Click the Student Planning submenu, then click on Plan and Schedule. In this page, you can view your planned courses per semester. Notice in the top right-hand corner, I'm getting an alert telling me that I'm not eligible to register. This is because I never completed those required agreements from earlier. Also notice how there are no options to register on this page. This is because at the time of this recording, registration for the summer 23, fall 23, and spring 24 semesters are still closed. When registration does open, there will be buttons under each class section that you can click to officially register for your planned courses. Later, we will jump into a different account and see how this will look for a second 9-week class in this spring 23 semester. The system will tell you if there are any conflicting or overlapping classes. In this schedule that we put together, two of the options we had for the College Success class are at the same time as the Art class. So let's click the X at the top right of the box for each section that we want to remove from our plan. If you didn't add multiple course options like we did with our College Success class, you can still see how other sections of the same course fit into your schedule by clicking on View Other Sections. You can even plan a different section right on this page. Any fully online courses will be listed here at the bottom under the Sections with No Meeting Time heading. Now let's go into that different account and see what it looks like to register for a class. This student is currently in a few classes, but I've blurred their schedule out for privacy's sake. What I want you all to focus on is this Ag 11 class that starts on March 20th. When registration for the next academic year opens up, this Register button will be available on your Plan and Schedule page. You also have the option to register for all planned classes using the Register Now button that's towards the top right. After registering for a class, the Register button will change to a Drop button. You can drop the class without penalty until the class starts. This student doesn't need this class, so let's go ahead and drop it for them. If you want to drop multiple classes, you can check any or all of the boxes in the dialog box that pops up. I only want to drop this Ag 11 class, so let's leave that checked and click the Update button here on the bottom. And that is the process for registering for classes using our newly redesigned student portal. Priority registration for the 2023-2024 academic year starts on March 20th, and open registration starts on April 11th. If you need any help registering, reach out to the Golden Eagle Admissions and Records team at 559-925-3317 or the Falcon Admissions and Records team at 559-934-2000. Have a great rest of your semester.